Here's a Christmas Day present for you. NBA basketball, and it's brought to you by ESPN on EA Sports. I'm Jalen Rose. The Chicago Bulls are readying themselves for an Eastern Conference showdown against the Brooklyn Nets. ESPN's number one team of Mike Green and Jeff Van Gundy are ready with the call.
Welcome to the Barclays Center in Brooklyn, New York. It's a Christmas Day special here on ESPN as we get set for the Brooklyn Nets looking for their 10th win of the season against the Chicago Bulls. As we close in on game time, let's take a look at tonight's starting lineups. All right, as this game gets underway, what is the key to success for Brooklyn here tonight?
You never want to be mediocre in this league. This team is stuck in Mediocrityville. It's a city that no NBA team wants to go to, but many dwell in that community nevertheless. So, how do you get from mediocrity to prosperity? Do you change management, coach, players? Something's got to change, or they will be stuck in this mediocre place for a long period of time.
To Heinrich. The two defenders converge. Nobody near him. Takes the three. Can't connect from way downtown. Williams jump shot. That's good.
There's nothing prettier than seeing a big-time shooter knocking a three from straight on.
Heinrich brings it across. To Boozer. Oh, he shoots it. And Kevin Garnett with more good effort, forcing that tough shot. Gets to the rim. No other rebound.
Even great shooters are distracted by a great closeout and a hard contest.
To Boozer. And it's a turnover. Nice little dump off. Looks to the post. Forces it up with the jump hook. Boozer the rebound.
It's hard to close out on great shooters. Tremendous job right there, getting his hand up, mirroring the ball.
Boozer's working hard, trying to back down his opponent.
Oh, that's a nice dunk right there.
Williams fires away, off balance, and that won't go. Boozer for the layup. He got a piece of it. Williams. To Lopez. Inside. The layup, no good.
Hey, that's a good look right there. Just couldn't get it in.
Luol Deng with the ball. To Boozer. With no room to shoot, can't hit the two.
Tremendous job making it difficult to get the ball to the basket.
To Lopez. Looking to dominate down low. Goes to the goal. An easy layup, but it won't go. Dang. To Boozer. To the basket and gets it to go.
Solid fundamental layup, but look at the explosive athleticism to drive up to the basket.
Lopez. He shoots, unable to flip it in. To the rim, able to hit.
Pound the offensive board. Get extra possession. Great job in the pursuit of the basketball and then finishing at the rim.
To Dang. for two. And Luol Deng with a nice look sinks it. 4 minutes gone by in the first. Brooklyn down by one. To Garnett. To Williams. Puts it up for two. Boozer the rebound. Dang, plenty of time. That's a three-pointer. Won't go from downtown. To Williams. Garnett. To Williams. Sweet dish. Oh, he slams it through. Boozer leans back for two. It'll count if it goes. Buzzer sounds. That ends the first quarter. Brooklyn down by one. More basketball here on Christmas Day on ESPN after the break. First quarter, nice tight game. This got a chance to be a good one, Jeff.
I'm really excited to see both of these teams, if they can continue to play at this level. Good, solid NBA game right now because both teams playing very well.
Oh, can't get it to drop.
No paint game, no winning. You've got to get the ball at the basket, and then you've got to finish when you get it there.
Excellent ball movement around the perimeter. Good setup with the entry pass. Backing his way down in the post. Tightly guarded, gets off the jump hook. Hits the shot. Three-point lead for Chicago.
That's a big-time shot right there.
Can Darren Williams be the starting point guard on an NBA championship team?
Darren Williams absolutely can be the starting point guard on a championship team. He too has had health issues. But if he's healthy and he's right mentally, he has a chance, I believe, to have an MVP type season. And now it might not be the same scoring numbers, but maybe his assist goes up substantially. Maybe he does a great job in leading this franchise by sacrificing his own offense for the betterment of the team. I think Darren Williams had a lot of problems with the Nets when they had to go through all that losing coming out of Utah, where they did all that winning. And I think that negatively impacted both his game and his attitude. I thought he got back to it last year and started to play much, much better. And I think this year he'll have a tremendous, tremendous year.
Blotch's attempt won't go. Able to hit. Kirilenko. Blatch. To Kirilenko. Quick passing around the perimeter. To Blatch. Kirilenko. Blatch. With no room. Dunleavy the rebound. To Snell. Shot is blocked. 3 minutes gone by in the second. The Nets up by one. Blatch can't knock it down. Dunleavy. Excellent ball movement around the perimeter. To Dunleavy. Gets it off. That's a two-pointer. And they miss another one. Haven't been able to score now in over 3 minutes. Puts it up. Count it. Plus the foul.
That's great body control right there. Finishes the shot and now goes to the free throw line.
And he can't convert the free throw. Tony Snell with it, taking it up to Dunleavy. Closely guarded, he fires. His jump shot won't go. To Blatch. Terry, he gets it to go. Excellent teamwork. An 8-0 run for the Nets. Dunleavy. It's blocked. Kirilenko, there's the foul and there's the whistle. The Bulls did not have a foul to give, so it'll be free throws.
Great effort by the defender trying to slide over and take the big time charge. Instead, hit with a blocking foul because he was just a count late.
Nope, first free throw won't go. Dang, the rebound. Pretty little pass. And they come up with a turnover. Slams it down. Dang. Final seconds. And the first half comes to an end. Andre Blatch with 6 points and 3 rebounds. Stay with us for more basketball here on Christmas Day after the break.
It's time for the EA Sports Halftime Report. I'm your host, Jalen Rose.
The Brooklyn Nets.
When you have a look at these highlights, you can see how this team was able to earn the halftime lead. They've been having a solid game here today. These are the guys getting buckets for the Brooklyn Nets.
The Chicago Bulls.
The Bulls didn't exactly set the world on fire with their offense in the opening quarter. And no matter what kind of defense you're playing, if you're not leading on the scoreboard, you're not winning the game. It really is that simple. These are the guys getting buckets for the Chicago Bulls. Tom Thibodeau and his players enjoyed a first half lead. And here it is with ESPN Wired.
Score, stop, score. Keep the ball in front. Hey, everyone's got a rebound. Everyone got a rebound.
Game track. Blocks.
The Chicago Bulls must be more thoughtful about this shot selection in the closing half of this matchup. Too many times they found themselves getting their shots swatted away. Now it's time to commit to the extra pass and use that against an increasingly eager defense.
Player of the half.
Blotch is leading all players in points and led all players for this selection. I'm thinking he made a promise to himself before the game that he was gonna own the paint with his offense. So far, he has not broken that promise. And here's the shot chart telling its own story.
Who was cold?
Gibson didn't exactly light it up in the first half. He's been able to get shots up, but more often than not, they just haven't been dropping for him. Let's check out his stats. The third quarter is about to get started. We give it back now to Mike and Jeff.